Hi, I'm Terry with SaveTheSkyRiver.org. I'm going to share some information with you today about a serious threat to the Skykomish River. Our message? Don't dam the Skykomish River. SaveTheSkyRiver.org is a grassroots organization formed to protect the Skykomish River from hydropower development. Many of us are also Snohomish County PUD ratepayers. Our supporters include American Whitewater, American Rivers, the Audubon Society, Hydropower Reform Coalition, North Cascades Conservation Council, the Mountaineers, Washington Wilderness Coalition, Friends of Haybrook Ridge, and the Sierra Club. The proposed project location is in Washington State, south of Highway 2, between milepost 35 and 36, on one of the last free-flowing rivers in the world. Over the past 100 years, this project site has been studied 5 times for hydropower development. And each time, it's been rejected. The Skykomish is the first river to be designated by Washington State as a scenic river. It has also been nominated for federal wild and scenic river designation. The proposed dam site has been declared a protected area from hydropower development by the Northwest Power and Conservation Council. This stretch of the Skykomish River is located in a designated critical habitat for ESA threatened species. Washington's Clean Energy Law specifically excludes new dams, in part as incentive to develop advanced solar, wind, and other new technologies. The proposed project would include a dam, an intake structure, a diversion tunnel, and a powerhouse. Water would be diverted from the river above Canyon Falls and fed into turbines located at the base of Sunset Falls. As part of their mitigation, PUD also plans to divert millions of ratepayer dollars to pay for upgrades to Department of Fisheries facilities at Sunset Falls. The dam and intake structure would be located here, within a short walk from the Wild Sky and Alpine Lakes Wilderness Area, as well as the Mount Baker Snoqualmie National Forest. Just downstream is Canyon Falls, which would be dramatically dewatered. About a mile further downstream is spectacular Sunset Falls, which would be reduced to a trickle. This is a slide from Snohomish County PUD showing what the intake structure would look like. Most of the structure would be tunneled into the bedrock and includes an elevator that goes down 19 stories. Hope that lady up on her cabin deck didn't mind all that blasting. Although PUD insists they can successfully mitigate any fish and wildlife issues, the sole purpose of this enormous structure is to screen out endangered fish and wildlife, or humans, from being sucked into the turbines and killed. It is 142 feet wide, 355 feet back into the granite, and 190 feet deep. Put into a perspective we can all see, it is about the size of the Seattle Seahawks football stadium. This project would be located within 1 mile of existing and proposed designated critical habitat areas. Other species of concern in the area are the peregrine falcon and the American bald eagle. Underground blasting will most certainly harm and displace the local aquatic birds. Among them are the harlequin ducks, mergansers, great blue heron, and the American dipper. Other wildlife that call the area home are black bears, Roosevelt elk, and a host of others, including our mascot, the North American river otter. There are numerous fish species that would somehow have to make their way past the dam, including ESA-threatened Chinook salmon and bull trout. The river above the dam is designated critical habitat for them. The Skykomish River is teeming with aquatic life and is therefore not a suitable location for a hydroelectric facility. Let's take a closer look at the proposed construction. 165,000 cubic yards of solid granite would have to be blasted and removed from the site. 35,000 cubic yards would be blasted for the underground diversion tunnel. This tunnel would be 19 feet in diameter and a half a mile long. Another 95,000 cubic yards for that intake cavern structure. Low impact? Hardly. This kind of impact could never be reversed. An additional 35,000 cubic yards would be blasted out of the bedrock at the base of Sunset Falls for the 9-story powerhouse. This would be a major construction project in an environmentally sensitive area. It would mean 440 million pounds of granite to be blasted and hauled away. It would mean tens of thousands of semi-truckloads coming and going on Highway 2, one of the most deadliest highways in the state. This PUD chart is misleading because it does not consider historic minimum flows. Only median and maximum flows are shown. What about low water years? The heavy red line indicates historic minimum flows, and the dashed blue line indicates the minimum flow required to operate at even 20% capacity. During low water years, the project could only run for 2 months out of the year, and then at less than 50% capacity. This would be a very significant investment of ratepayer funds. The overall amount of energy produced would only be a drop in the bucket. The water level in the river is lowest in the winter and the summer when power is needed most. Ratepayers would foot the bill for Department of Fisheries upgrades. Voters in Washington want more investment in energy efficiency, solar, wind, and other new technologies. What would be the gain? From PUD's own energy resource plan through the year 2022, small hydro will only account for less than 1% of the overall energy portfolio. Best-selling author Bill Bryson noted in 2010, "Of all of the energy produced on Earth since the Industrial Revolution began, half has been consumed in just the last 20 years. Hydro is last century's solution. The future requires an intense focus on energy efficiency improvements and new emerging clean energy technologies." We believe that Sunset Falls is not a viable site for a dam, and this river should be given federal wild and scenic river designation to protect it from any future threat of hydro development. So why is PUD still pursuing this project? In part, it's because of the process being used to make policy decisions. PUD employees are good people who are passionate about their work and about serving the public. They worked hard on this dam idea and are very excited about it. 6 of the 7 statements on this checklist presented by PUD are misleading. The existing Trappan Hall negates the natural barrier argument. Wild Sky Federal Wilderness is only 2.5 miles from Sunset Falls, and the Alpine Lakes Wilderness Area is only 9 miles away. The river has been recommended for federal wild and scenic designation and is a Washington State Scenic River. In fact, there has never been an environmental impact statement done on the Sunset Falls project. PUD studies are far from complete, so PUD cannot know if there are geological or other fatal flaws at this time. Above, PUD's presentation image of the intake site would lead you to believe this is just another stream. Below is the accurate image of the proposed intake site, a world-class scenic vista on par with any scenery in the Bavarian Alps, and uniquely located on one of the world's last free-flowing rivers, just over an hour's drive from downtown Seattle. The first photo is of Sunset Falls at present. The second is PUD's rendition after installing the powerhouse. It infers no change to the river flow. The third image is a more accurate rendition of how Sunset Falls would appear with the powerhouse and reduced water flows. In order to avoid making really bad policy decisions, it's extremely important to present all of the facts, not just the ones that support the proposal. Don't lock on to one idea. Present alternatives. Don't do a sales job. Ask the difficult questions. Spell out the worst-case scenarios. Resist the desire to believe and insist on evidence. PUD is quite capable of making bad policy decisions. If they ignore the lessons from the past, they are doomed to repeat them. There are no public roads to either Canyon Falls or Sunset Falls, and many people have never visited either. Many local residents and vacation property owners know the history of repeated rejections of proposed hydropower at this site and believe it could never happen, that it's just a rumor. But without our intervention, the dam could become a reality. The river cannot speak for itself. Therefore, it is up to us. We urge you to go to the website savetheskyriver.org to learn more and to sign the online petition. The biggest effect you can have at this time is to speak to the PUD commissioners directly, because they alone have the ability to stop this project before it begins. Also, make sure your elected officials are aware of your opposition to this project.